benefits of doing that. A person that knows how to thank God, praise the Lord, is a person of impact. And one of the things is this, praise the Lord, no one wants to invest in the life of a person that is ungrateful. It's true. You can help somebody, but when you discover that person is ungrateful, what you do, hallelujah, you disconnect yourself from that person. Amen. No one wants to promote somebody that is ungrateful. I remember about Jesus, heal, hallelujah, some people. In Luke chapter, hallelujah, 17, verse 17. He healed, hallelujah, a few people. Glory be to God. Among of them, Bible shows about there was 10, I didn't make a mistake. But among of the 10, praise the Lord, the 9, they didn't come back. There was only one that decides to come back. Hallelujah. To come and to appreciate, hallelujah, Jesus. When you are grateful, I promise you, your miracle will be permanent. When you are ungrateful, I promise you, you will lose even what you are receiving from God. That's why you see many people, they will come for breakthrough, and tomorrow they come, hallelujah, for another breakthrough. Because they are seeing breakthrough, breakdown, breakthrough, breakdown, breakthrough, breakdown. You know, when you have a car, like today, you are fixing it to the mechanic. After 1 week, you are going again to the mechanic. After 3 weeks, you are going to the mechanic. The advice is this, sell that car. Amen? Because by the time you finish with the mechanic, I promise you that mechanic is already take the amount of money that is more than that car. So I pray for you by the Spirit of God, may you become grateful. Because when you are thanking God, I promise you, thanksgiving, hallelujah, praise the Lord, glory be to God, is a attitude that every believer needs to carry. If you desire a next level in your life, if you desire your breakthrough or hallelujah, your miracle to be permanent, be grateful. Hallelujah. And thanking God. And the Bible shows about the one that, hallelujah, came to say thank you to Jesus was somebody, hallelujah, who was a foreigner. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. From Samaria. Hallelujah. Came to say thank you. The 9, they went to celebrate. But they didn't celebrate with the Lord. In everything, every achievement in life, learn to give thanks unto God. You know what? When you are not giving thanks unto God, you know what you are saying to God? Everything that I receive today, I receive it with my own power, with my own energy, with my own connection. But when you are thanking God for the people that God brings in your life, you are acknowledge God like God. If this person is believing me, it's because you touch his heart. So for that reason, I thank you for the connection. You are married, thank God for your partner. Thank God for your marriage. What you celebrate, you appreciate. What you celebrate, you appreciate. You want to, hallelujah, you want, hallelujah, to appreciate and to see the hand of God in every aspect of your life. Start to thank God for your children. If you start to thank God for your children, you will never abuse them, and that God will keep them for you. I can't hear you loud, the amen. When you are thanking God for your marriage, God will protect your marriage, and that God will keep your marriage. I can't hear you loud, the amen. That person that came to say thank you to Jesus, I believe his miracle was permanent. Hallelujah. The rest, they went to celebrate. And for that reason, their miracle could not be permanent. I pray for you, may your miracle be permanent in Jesus' name. When you are grateful, I promise you, you'll be graceful in life. You want to see more grace of our Lord Jesus. More grace for you to see miracles upon miracles, favor upon favor. Every day, give thanks unto the Father. Thanksgivings is what we do every day in our life. May God give you the grace for you to see that in Jesus' name. Number two, hallelujah, praise the Lord. The only one access, hallelujah, access to the presence of the Lord is by thanking God. Even God is expecting you when you come to his presence to not come in his presence with your prayer card, but to come first with thanksgivings. Yes, I have a prayer card. Yes, I have, hallelujah, the things that I want God to do for me. But the first things, God, I thank you for my life. God, I thank you for what I have. God, I thank you for the privilege and the honor that you give to me to be in your presence. When you are thanking God, I promise you, God, he will welcome you, hallelujah, in the Holy of Holies. God will welcome you in his glory. I can't hear you loud, amen. Psalm 100, hallelujah, verse 4. Enter in his gate with thanksgivings and his court with praise. You want to enter in the glory of glory. You want to see the power of the Almighty God. Open your heart and start to celebrate Elohim for what he's doing in your life daily. The more you are celebrating him, the more you will enter in the glory of glory. I can't hear you loud, amen. It's not everybody that the devil can destroy. There are some people they can say in the name of Jesus Christ the devil is coming to them, but there are some people that they stand in the Holy of Holies, in the presence of the Almighty God. Their prayer alone, hallelujah, when they are speaking, is like God is speaking through them. I come to declare over your life, before you arrive to a place, the angels of God, they will prepare a place for you in the name of Jesus Christ. If you are the one, can I hear a ladder? Amen. I say again, before you arrive to a place, the angels of God, they will go before you. Hallelujah. Exodus, hallelujah, 23, verse 20. See, I send the angels ahead of you. Hallelujah. Before you arrive to play, life is the grand of offering. You like it or not. Life is not give to you what you deserve. Never forget that. Life is not give to you what you deserve, but life is give to you what you demand. It's not because God give you a promise, oh God, he can do everything that he said, praise the Lord, no matter the matter. No, you will die in that same level. You need to demand what is belong to you. That's why when you come to this church like this one, you are engage yourself in prayer. You know what God sent you in this prophetic church? It's because your case is take only Elohim. Praise the Lord. Without this anointing that is here, I promise you, you will die with story. I can't tell you like that. That's why the devil is bringing people that they are distract you. They want to distract you left and right. Left and right. Why? Because the devil wants you to be in distraction. And when you are in distraction, the devil can't take what is belong to you. Let me say to you, the devil can't take your gifts. If somebody say, I see the devil is stealing your gift, is a lie. The devil can't steal your gifts, but the devil can delay you. He has the power to delay you. If you are a doctor, you are a doctor. No matter if the devil himself and demon are coming, you're already a doctor. It's finished. They can't take that. Hallelujah, somebody. If you know how to play instruments, you know it. That, hallelujah, grace, no one can take it. No one can take it. The wisdom that God gave to Solomon, even when Solomon backslides, hallelujah, is God to take that gift? The wisdom? No, the wisdom was there, but the devil used it now as his platform to destroy people. But I come to declare over your life, huh? I declare by the Spirit of God, any form of delay, it will never come near your life in the name of Jesus. Yes, you are feeling discouraged left and right because of certain things that you went through, but don't worry. Go now in the presence of the Almighty God, start to appreciate him, start to give glory unto God. Let me say to you, every day is not the same. The heat of yesterday is different with the heat of today. I can't hear you loud, amen. Everybody, if you are a taxi driver, I promise you, it's not easy to drive all day. When I was small, before I buy the car, I was just thinking about to drive. That is a small job. Try to drive all morning. From morning until 1 o'clock, your body is finished. To drive is a hard work. It's a hard work. It's a hard work. Praise the Lord. There is no work on the planet that is easy. Glory be to God. There is no work that is easy. But I pray for you by the Spirit of God. I pray no devil will put you down. If you are the one, can I hear a ladder? Amen. No devil will put you down in the name of Jesus. Remember one thing. The devil can't take your gifts. But the devil have the power to delay you. I can delay you. He can bring people, hallelujah, time waster around you. People that are telling you story upon story, but they delay you. Story upon story. But today I come to declare over your life, every time waster in your area, any time waster that is coming closer to you, I remove that time waster in the name of Jesus. God, you will never give room to that time waster. In the name of Jesus, when you are thanking God, you'll be in the Holy of Holies. You'll be in the glory of God. And for that reason, what destroy other people, it can't destroy you. When things are tight and complicated in your life, start to thank God. So that you can win the heat of today. So that you can win the challenge of today. Maybe this morning you are feeling discouraged, but I want to encourage you. Use the weapon of thanking God. Your dream, you'll bring problem in your life. I can't tell you like that, man. There's some day that you feel like you are playing. There's some day that you feel like, hallelujah, other people that overtake you. But let me say to you, when you are thanking God, your strength will come back. I pray for you, may that strength come back to you. If you are the one, can I hear a louder amen? I say, may that strength of God come back to you. If you are the one, can I hear a louder amen? I say, when you are thanking God, you are pleasing God. Because by thanking God, you are making God happy. And when you are pleasing God, I promise you, God will make you happy too. When you are thanking God, you are touching the heartbeat of God. God, I thank you. God, I thank you for my life. God, I thank you for my family. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. Hallelujah. In everything, give thanks. You are not giving thanks. Let me humble you. Everybody can give thanks unto God when they have money in their pockets. When the bank is full, you already pay your rent, you already buy a house, you are driving a nice expensive car. Praise the Lord, you can enter in any shop, expensive shop, and swapping your card, and you don't even think twice. What about the person that you don't know? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Is there already the 31st? You don't know how you're going to pay his rent. The bank is writing minus. There is no connection around. Then give thanks unto God. You don't give thanks unto God because good things is happening in your life. You are thanking God, hallelujah, for everything. God, I thank you for today. As I put all my trust in you, I know you are in control. Even those that don't have money for the rent, I know you are in control. I remember a few days I was in this lockdown, God bless us. I was actually, praise the Lord, I came to the church, picked some stuff. God said, go knock by so and so place. I just arrived. I'm coming just to visit you. Remember, I can't greet you. I can't shake your hand. Bye-bye. This is something from the boot. The person said, God Almighty, we didn't have nothing. I was praying unto God. That is God. God can use anybody when you are thanking God. Remember, when you are thanking God, God, you put the angels at work to take you out from where you are. Everybody on earth a problem. I can't hear a lot of men. Everybody on earth feel the heats of life. But your thanksgivings is provoking, make God happy on his throne of grace. His feeling is Elohim. And for that reason, what he said, whatever things that you want, because I can see your heart, I give it to you. I pray for you. What you want, may God give to you. I can't hear your ladder, amen. I say, what you want, may God give to you. I want a house, God, you give to me. Hallelujah. I want a property, God, you give to me. I want a business, God, you give to me. I want connection, God, you give to me. Whatever things that you want, God, you give to you. You are serving a father that is in control. The whole world is in his hand. The whole world is in the hand of God. The heart of a king, the heart of a person that is in power is in the hand of God. God can decorate you, hallelujah, in 1 second. God can make you rich in 1 minute. It's take only God's heart for your life to change. Touch the heartbeat of God. I promise you, you'll be, hallelujah, a person of victory. Think about it. If God today, he wants to change your story, he can give you just a small rock. He give you just a small rock, a small diamond that is in this size. He said, just small for you to manage you and your family. I said, thank you, Jesus. You know, when somebody say, like, manage this, no one thinks he's speaking in parable. You can't give somebody turn around and you say, manage it. Manage. When somebody says, manage this, check something. He's speaking in tongue. I pray for you. May God give you grace for you to win in Jesus' name. I see favor is coming to you. The connection is coming to you. Number four. Is it number four? Glory be to God. Number four. Praise the Lord. Thanksgiving is to magnify God. In another way, hallelujah, is to glorify Him. When you are thanking God, you are glorifying God. And for that reason, God also, you allow people to honor you. I pray may God honor you in every aspect. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Psalm 69, verse 30. Psalm 69. Are you blessed, somebody? Say, I will bless the Lord for the rest of my life. Hallelujah. Do you believe that God is good? Hallelujah. I not only believe that God is good, I know God is good. And my God is good at all time. Glory be to God. I see God favor you. I see God decorate you. I see God increase you. In the name of Jesus. Psalm, hallelujah, 69, verse 30, what the Bible say. Praise the Lord. Let's look about 29. Bible say, I am suffering and in pain. Rescue me, O God, by your saving power. Full stop. Then I will praise God's His name with singing. And I will honor Him with thanksgivings. Hallelujah. For this is, hallelujah, this will please the Lord more than sacrifice. Hallelujah. What will please God more than sacrifice is what? Thanksgivings. Hallelujah. The sacrifice that we bring unto God is a sacrifice of thanksgivings. God, I'm grateful for what you are doing in my life. For that reason, I come to honor you with the gifts that you give to me. You give me the gift of life, so I honor you with my life. Hallelujah. You bless me financially. I come to give thanksgiving with my finances. Glory be to God. I can't hear you louder, amen. You give me my children. We are coming to dance in the house of the Lord together, giving you thanks so that you can keep them more for me. I come to declare over your life everything that is belong to you. Huh? May become, hallelujah, praise the Lord, a thanksgiving unto Lord. And I declare by the Spirit of God, nothing will put you down in Jesus' name. I'll finish by this because of time. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. We say this. Thanksgivings bring balance. Think about your life, your Christian walk without thanksgivings. Think about your prayer life without thanking God. You'll be just, God, give me. God, give me. Breakthrough, breakdown. God, give to me. God, give. You'll be just asking God. And you'll be a selfish. Because thanksgivings, it always removes you from selfish life. From self-centered. Is put now your focus on the Lord. A Christian that you don't know how to thank God, is easy for that Christian to backslide. A Christian that don't know how to thank God, that Christian, he can be manipulated easily by a false teaching. Because your Christian walk must have balance. You may not know scripture, too much scripture, but know the power of thanking God. I promise you, you will discover false prophets. False pastor, you will discover them. False servant, because where there is right servant, there is also false servant. Hallelujah, somebody. So when you know how to thank God, if in like when you are in pain, in difficult moment, you will know what the advice that they give to me is not scripture, it's not from God. The advice that they give to me is scripture. Because when you are thanking God, you become a balanced Christian. If in your prayer life you become a prayer, hallelujah, that is balanced. Start your prayer with thanksgivings. and finish it with thanksgivings. So start your prayer by thanking God for your life, and then finish your prayer by thanking God for answer your prayer. I promise you, your life will be a life of victory. Start your day by thanking God. When you are doing your work, thanking God. And then when you are finished, thanking Him. And then when you are doing that, I promise you, your Christian life will be balanced. Your prayer will be a prayer of power. Look about our Lord Jesus Christ. When He multiplied bread, Bible shows us about something. He gave thanks unto the Father. Miracle happened. Miracle always happen in our life as a believer. We access, hallelujah, glory be to God, to the power of the Almighty God when we are giving thanks unto the Father. No matter what you feel, don't allow your heart to refuse to praise God, to thank God. And let me say this by this, thanksgivings bring joy, because you can't thank God and be saved. So that means thanksgivings can dictate your mood. Your business can dictate your mood. Your challenge of life can dictate your move, your mood. The way that your boss treats you at your work can dictate your move, your mood. But, hallelujah, thanksgivings enforce joy in our life. Because you can't thank God and not, hallelujah, praise the Lord, be joyful. And Bible said, the joy of the Lord is our strength. When you are moody, you start to think negative things. You start to think about rejection. There are so many people that they went through many things like me. But in their life, there is a mark of rejection. Everything that they're doing in life, they're doing based on rejection. They don't trust people. They don't trust nobody. Why? Because God didn't deal with that pain in their life. But when you start to thank God, I promise you, God will flush out the atmosphere of other people, the attitude of other people. If there is bad people, there is good people. I can't hear your loud amen. If they say there is a false, that means there is a hallelujah. I remember, praise the Lord, we have Adidas and we have Abibas. Abibas could be original if they could have their own logo. If you buy during the night, you think like you are buying Adidas, but when you wake up in the morning, is there Abibas? Now you need to see if they can remove one letter. Friend, I come to declare over your life, thanksgiving is a powerful thing. So let me say to us, praise the Lord, I pray today by the Spirit of God, go with the Spirit of God. Go and make it. No devil, it will stop somebody that is thanking God. I declare you are unstoppable. I declare you are unshakable. I declare you are unmovable. Go and dominate by the Spirit of God. I declare Cape Town to produce the best for you. I declare the world to accept you. I declare the world to produce the best for you. I declare the heart of king to be open for you. I declare the heart of business people to accept you. I declare no weapon from against you prosper. I declare the land to produce the best. In the name of Jesus, go and win, go and shine, go and dominate. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.